A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th December, on the front page you have NPR, House to House Verification Plan. So data on parents' place of birth will be gathered under National Population Register, and register already has data of 119 crore citizens. So National Population Register will be updated for 2021 census. So this exercise has become controversial because of the citizenship rules of 2003. So the citizenship rules link the population register to creation of a National Register of Indian Citizens, NRIC, which can form the basis for or which is actually the NRIC which is planned, National Register of Citizens. So some states we had seen had said they would not conduct NPR also. They have stopped NPR and they have clearly stated they would not be having NRC in their state. So this is regarding the questions which are asked in the NRC NPR form. So that you can see the year of birth, age, and also the place of birth of parents are mentioned in the form. And this is the detail given regarding how to come up with the age of a person. So age of a person, a year of birth of a person may be linked to some significant event, historical event which has taken place, like you can see First World War, Dandi March, or you know, liberation of Bangladesh, Asian Games, India's first win in cricket World Cup in 1983. So that can be linked to find the age of a person. And it is said if the respondent does not know the age of any person, any member of the household, and asking questions also does not help in arriving at the age of the person, then the enumerator will have to estimate the age of that person using the best judgment. So that is what NPR data is going to collect the details. Then this is Army Chief: leading crowds of arson is not leadership. So this is Army Chief General Bipin Rawat, who has said leaders are not those people who lead people in inappropriate direction, as we are witnessing in large number of university and college students. Leaders are those who lead people in the right direction. So this is a statement which he has given on the protests across the country against Citizenship Amendment Act. So it is unusual for a serving army chief to comment on country's civilian affairs, and the remarks have drawn sharp criticism on social media and from political parties. On page 8, you have Nambi Narayanan to get 1.3 crore rupees. So this is ex-ISRO scientist Nambi Narayanan. He had been in a spy scandal case. So he has now filed a case against the state, against the government, in the sub court in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. He is from Kerala, and Kerala cabinet has also decided in principle to give him 1.3 crore rupees as such. So this is in addition to the 50 lakh which has been provided to him on the basis of Supreme Court order, and 10 lakh recommended by the NHRC. So he had been incorrectly put in this spy scandal case and had spent a large part of his time behind bars when he was a scientist. So he has filed case against the government now. You can see it was in September 2018 that the Supreme Court ruling came. The Supreme Court found him guilty of trumped up allegations of espionage by Kerala police. So the court has ordered the state government to pay him 50 lakh rupees as compensation for loss of his fundamental right to live with dignity and self-respect for all these years since his arrest in 1994. On page 9, you have Supreme Court outlines three conditions for stay orders. So Supreme Court has outlined three aspects it usually considers while granting a stay order. So here you can see the three conditions are: the balance of convenience does not favor the alleged violator, the stay order does not cause irreparable harm or injury, and there should be a prima facie case for granting the stay order. So these are the three conditions Supreme Court says on the basis of its stay order, means whatever ruling has been given or whatever action has been taken, it is stayed, will not be put into effect. And this is UGC issues norms for ethics in higher education. So these norms actually call for modesty, harmony. So these are new guidelines for values and ethics in higher education. on editorial page, the first editorial is endless wait. So this is regarding the prolonged election process in Afghanistan. So it says this will do little to end the political instability in the country. And we have seen about Afghan elections, the presidential elections, where President Ashraf Ghani has won with 50.64% of the votes counted. So if the Independent Election Commission, if this is ratified, will obviate the need for second round of polling, otherwise second round of polling is required. And this is cracks in the relic. So this is regarding NATO. So the downturn in Turkey's relation with US holds implications for the future of NATO. So Turkey-US relations are being hurt. So the tensions are evident. We have seen US and Turkey, they are the largest and second largest standing armies. They have the standing armies at NATO respectively. And then US nuclear warheads are also in Incirlik Air Base, a critical facility for American operations in West Asia. So Turkey is a significant member of NATO. And the strain in relations will have its consequences. So the strains have been developing since US is supporting the Kurdish rebels in Syria against the Islamic State. So later, after the Islamic State has been eliminated, we saw US gave Turkey a free hand to fight against the Kurds. And later again, US joined in support of the Kurds. By the time, Turkey had taken support of Russia because USA moved out of Syria. So Turkey, to fight against the Kurds, it took support of Russia also. So making Turkey go closer to Russia will be detrimental to NATO. So that's what this editorial talks about. The lead article, the data protection bill only weakens users' rights. So this is regarding the data protection bill, which has been now referred to a joint parliamentary committee. So it says a culmination of flawed policy proposals. This piece of legislation will refine, store and trade personal information. So what it speaks of is, here you can see the scale of data collection is ambitious and broadly contained in Digital India program. So the amount of data which will be collected is huge. So in the view of some technologists, this also fulfills geostrategic goals when personal data is viewed as strategic state resource. Then another concern which is raised is regarding, here you can see, data is a public good. That is a concern. So then here you can see elites' preference for privacy on the poor who care for better quality of living the most. Such are the arguments which have been given, you know, in the bill. So privacy is a right for all, irrespective of them being an elite or poor. Then below you have Assam's identity fears face up to divisive politics. So protests in Assam have been brought about by BJP's failure to gauge the popular mood. So Assam has been spearheading protests against the Citizenship Amendment Act now. So that is detailed out here, how the provisions are a threat to indigenous people, and the northeastern states have raised their voice, though almost all northeastern states have been excluded either through them being part of Schedule 6 of the Constitution, and tribal areas in those regions, or through the inner line permit system through which they are excluded from Citizenship Amendment Act. But some parts of Assam and Tripura are still under the provisions of the Citizenship Amendment Act. Then on OPED page, you have on Fridays a Parle coverage. So this is view counter view given on Citizenship Amendment Act. So the questions are, what are the amendments that Citizenship Amendment Act needs? So it says India should ensure a clear, non-discriminatory and inclusive refugee policy. So this is the detail given regarding Citizenship Amendment Act here, and the views, counter views on these amendments. And this is disrupting the gender-blind political recourse in India. So this is discourse. So this is regarding affirmative action, which is required to empower more women in the country. On international page, you have continuation of old news, and this Russian government's action against opposition political leader. And these are protests in Hong Kong, protests in Iraq. So this is there. Here is an important news. This is China, Russia, and Iran to hold naval drills in Gulf of Oman. So the three countries will hold joint naval drills in the Gulf of Oman. And here it is at a time when the tensions between USA are high because against Iran after it has withdrawn from the nuclear deal. So this is a detail given. It says exercise would stabilize security in the region and benefit the world. So for Iran also, the drill's purpose was to bolster international commerce, security in the region, and fight terrorism and piracy. On business page, you have more 5G spectrum sale on anvil. So telecom department has sought tries telecom regulatory authority of India's views on auction of 24.75 to 27.25 gigahertz band 2. So more 5G spectrum sale would take place presently in 2020. So this sale is proposed to be held towards the end of 2020. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.